Most of Ontarians agree that Doug Ford has massively failed in handling this pandemic. However, some in the UK are arguing that their leader, Boris Johnson, is actually doing a far worse job. So to settle this once and for all, we've invited UK's own Danny George. Hello, Danny.
Oh, hey there, buddy.
Okay, let's keep it civil here. And to ensure that we do, please welcome our debate moderator and a master debater in his own right, Jeremy Friedmann.
Okay, wow. Real mature, Korri. I'm not a master debater. I'm a mass debater, as in I debate people during Easter Mass.
Okay, I'm sorry. Mass debater, Jeremy Friedmann.
And masturbator. Now, let the debate night begin!
Debate night.
Now for our opening arguments. We start with the Right Honorable Corald Birch.
Thank you, Jeremy. And now, Doug Ford is easily the worst of the two leaders, okay? His half measures have allowed this pandemic to rage on for much longer than they should have. He's bungled paid sick leave over and over again. He tried to bring back carding, for God's sake, and he looks like a melting stick of butter wearing a wig.
Well, your last point is actually the only thing I like about Doug Ford. And now for your opening statement, the Left Honorable Donald George.
Thank you. Well, Boris Johnson has failed to take COVID seriously, despite catching it himself, was overheard saying he'd rather let bodies pile high into the thousands than lock down the UK again, and somehow he looks like a depressed stepdad caught in a wind tunnel.
Okay, and now, as is customary in master debatery, it's time for a short recess. All right, and now let's get back into the heat of the meat with rebuttals. So bring that lukewarm Earl Grey energy, Danny.
Thank you. Well, Corey, you Canadian cuck, at least your boy Doug Ford got a haircut. Boris Johnson chooses to have that uncut hairstyle. COVID aside, his hair alone proves that Boris Johnson is an unrepentant sociopath. You, Corey, are a Doug Ford-loving, beaver taint-sniffing bitch.
Harsh, but entirely accurate. Your polite Canadian rebuttal, Corey.
Danny, you tea-swilling toast sucker, I know you're secretly in love with Boris Johnson because he's the father figure you never had, whereas Dougie Ford is an incompetent oaf who, like your actual father, told us that he was going out for cigarettes and abandoned us, just like you, little orphan Danny. Please, sir, can I have some more?
Sounds like Daddy Corey might have some daddy issues. Now, closing statements! Go ahead.
Corey, you're a maple syrup sucking sod. You look like if Macaulay Culkin grew up and joined the Sticky Bandits, and your lips are far too big.
Okay, Danny, you spotted dick, bangers and trash, chimney sweet daddy's brown sauce sucker. You look like the secret son of Pierce Morgan, who he's kept locked in his windowless basement and hasn't seen the sun in decades.
That's just what English people look like. I'm sorry I was so mean.
Well, Danny, I'm sorry too. I only say hurtful things because I love you.
I love you too, Daddy Corey.
Aw, and also ew. But we can all agree that was certainly something to master debate about.